Hello, this is Salil, co-founder of AdNapu. We have apps for Shopify, and one of our apps is for Google Shopping in Shopify. But today's topic, I'm going to talk about Google Merchant Center issues as a broad topic, right? So this will be applicable even if you're not using Shopify. Today's topic is about tax-related issues. These issues only, only those stores which are selling in the United States is affected because of this issue. And I'll highlight the main problems, right? I'll divide into two, right? One is that you don't have tax available for a certain state or a certain PIN code, etc. Let's see in Google Merchant Center where you can see this, right? You can see this as sales tax. So if you click on settings button, you'll see it in the sales tag. And I have disabled, the California tax rate here, just to show you guys what how this error would look like. So what happens is that Google will crawl with different PIN codes, right? And if any for any of the PIN code, if they find that the tax rate is not matching with the website, they will flag your product and it can get disapproved, right? So here you can see, because I have a California PIN code, I don't have any tax rate. And if Google finds this out, there's a high likelihood that they will disapprove this product, and this product will not be eligible to advertise anywhere in the United States. So it's problem number one is if you don't have tax rates for any country, sorry, any state or a PIN code. So ensure that you are covering all the states here. Typically, what I've seen is that in Shopify, some people will go for Google determined sales tax, which is an automatic calculation. You can do that. Or if you have a custom calculation, you can go for that as well. There are a few more settings, like whether shipping and handling is also taxable. This all depends on your store and your policies, right? So the first issue was tax settings not being available. Second issue, which I think is more nuanced and more complicated, is when you have a tax setting that shows a lower value in Google Merchant Center, but a higher value when you try to check out a product, right? This Google considers as a bigger issue. And I have seen even accounts getting suspended due to this issue, right? They will give you a couple of warnings. And if you repeat, if you're a repeat offender, you can even get your Merchant Center account itself banned. So be very, very careful about it. The issue is that for Google, they want their customers to know the accurate tax value, right? Even if you show a higher tax value in Google Merchant Center, that is still okay. Right? Because they expect a higher value, but when they do a checkout, it comes out to a lower number, right? That's acceptable by Google. But if the tax value that you show in Google Merchant Center is actually lower than the one on your website, you are in trouble. So stay away from that. So just to recap, a lower tax rate in Google Merchant Center compared to your website is a problem. A higher tax rate is okay. Higher tax rate is, however, not good for your conversion. You don't want to show, you don't want to scare away your customers, right? You want to be as accurate as possible. But sometimes that's not easy to do, right? Sometimes you have even, the state taxes, there are situations where some states and in some territories, you have a higher tax rate than others. So the perfect uniformity might not be possible. But if you want to err on the side of higher tax rates in Google Merchant Center, I hope after watching this video, you are able to figure out the issues with your Merchant Center. If there is anything related to tax rates, do let us know whether you found this video useful, and please subscribe to our channel. Thank you.